profile growth is obviously to put a policy framework for financing and leasing of aircraft from domestic firms. This brings predictability, this brings cushion against exchange rate risks, and a good way to start could be through leasing and financing of helicopters. Growth in aviation doesn't just mean focusing and growing airlines or the fixed wing sector. India is a vast country with terrains that are at times not accessible by fixed wing aircraft. This is where focus on growing and enhancing the use of helicopters comes into play and is very crucial. Currently, India as a country has only about 250 flying helicopters in the civil and parapublic market. This is less than the number of helicopters that we have just in the city of São Paulo in Brazil. While the RCS scheme is expected to boost the use of helicopters to connect regions with difficult terrains, there are areas where we need to get started where helicopter deployment will play a critical role in saving lives. One success story here is the deployment of helicopters for Char Dham and pilgrimage yatras such as Amarnath. There are over 50 takeoffs happening just from one helipad for the pilgrimage season to ferry pilgrims to the holy shrines. And this has resulted in creation of hundreds of jobs just in that one little pocket where the helicopter takeoffs and connectivity to the pilgrimage shrines has been enabled. Imagine that extending to across the country. We are looking at creating hundreds of thousands of jobs just by enabling some infrastructure for helicopter connectivity. Across the country today, we have about 150,000 fatalities per year on roads. That translates to over 400 a day. And the use of helicopters for emergency medical services can play a huge role in saving lives of our citizens. And this can be enabled just by regulations, the right regulations. The use of helicopters for unmanned aerial vehicles for law enforcement, firefighting, surveillance, urban air mobility in clogged cities will provide significant advantage and again create thousands of jobs. Finally, all this needs to be done keeping the environment and safety in mind, which means the use of technology and technologically superior equipment which is less fuel consuming and obviously is less emitting the greenhouse gases. Incentivizing the use of modern technology to deploy the state-of-the-art equipment, phasing out obsolete equipment like aging helicopters and replacing them with light and fuel efficient one, it certainly will result in helping and to curb emissions and for us to drive sustainable growth for the aviation industry. It's clear that we are off to a flying start in aviation. Accelerating sustainable growth will require opening the skies further through a policy framework that could make us a world leader, not just the third largest aviation market in the world. Thank you so much.